Hey YouTube, welcome back to the Obi Thor Alliance. What are you doing today, Jacob?
I am reviewing a movie called Shotgun Wedding.
So stick around if you want to see what Jacob thought of Shotgun Wedding. So, Shotgun Wedding. So you've seen it, I haven't.
Yes.
This is what it says so far about it. So it stars Lopez and Josh Duhamel. J-Lo, famous for singing. Josh Duhamel, we've seen in...
Transformers.
11-22-63. Las Vegas, he's in 106 episodes of that apparently. So, you know, he's been in a few things. Very recognizable face. Lenny Kravitz as well. That's pretty interesting. And we've got Jennifer Coolidge was mum from the American Pie series. So, got some decent names in it.
Movie on Amazon Prime.
So, Amazon Prime original. Its storyline says here, basically they're doing going on a wedding and the wedding party gets taken and they have to save the wedding party all before they kill themselves. So, I'm guessing it's a bit of a, not a romantic comedy, but has funny moments and they somehow stumble into saving people even though they're not qualified and know what they're doing.
Yeah.
In essence.
So basically what happens is that the man wants to make a perfect wedding for the bride, and then basically they invite both family members, both sides of the family, and then he chooses the Philippines, and then everyone's invited except for the ex, and then the husband of Jennifer Lopez's character invites the ex, and then from there we get the movie, and then they have an argument that causes why they're not with the bride and groom's party. Everyone from the hotel area gets vacated to the pool area, and the hotel staff, we don't really know what happens to them. So basically, pirates are involved with the movie, and basically from there, the pirates want money.
Okay, so they then have to rescue the bridal party, basically.
Yeah.
It's done well. Is it interesting? You like it?
Unfortunately, found it kind of boring. Entertaining, yes, but not that interesting with what goes on with the movie. There is a twist involved. But besides that, it felt not that interesting, unfortunately.
Okay, so give us a verdict. What rating did you give it and why?
I gave it a 61% out of 100. The main points that it got was its acting. I do feel like the acting performances, the actors give a good performance, but the writing, plot, and everything else just fell apart. Unfortunately, the actors can't control it. The plot isn't as good as the acting, so that's what let it down for me. And it's very one-dimensional of how, of course, the bride and the groom weren't with everyone else because there wouldn't be a moving. And what really annoys me in those situations is that the people, the guns, don't necessarily win. And of course, the good guys win at the end of the day. It's very by the book sort of movie.
Yeah, it seems, without even seeing it, I feel like I could predict and like already know how this movie goes, and there's no point watching it. I just feel like it's something that's been done before, but change of location, change of actors, somewhat change of circumstance, but it's a movie, you know, that's been done over and over, really.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, so bottom line, is it worth your time, worth watching it?
No, unless you got like good banter and comedy, I would say not. There are some funny moments that I did laugh, but besides that, it was kind of, this isn't really worth the time, unfortunately.
If someone had to watch it, who do you think it would suit, and when would be a time to watch it? Is it, you know, like a quick watch you'd watch with a loved one, just, you know, a Friday night, you don't pay much attention to it, or is it more of a serious watch movie you need to pay attention?
No, you don't need to pay attention. I would say it's for fans of Jennifer Lopez and for couples that would go, would this actually happen in a wedding scenario? Like, it's a sort of movie if you actually think about it. Like the plot is not it's just not believable, unfortunately.
Do you think it could be made better, or just the whole premise is overdone and, you know, it's as good as it could have been based upon what they had to work with?
It definitely could have been made better, but it's just been done so many times that the writing was just not good.
Yeah, it doesn't make me excited to watch it. I feel like maybe because it is a quick watch, well, I don't know if it's a quick watch, but it seems like it's a simple watch. It's somewhat appealing, but, you know, with a review like that, maybe I might waste my time.
Shall we get into spoilers?
Yeah, let's spoil it a bit.
So basically with the groom, he actually got information that this island was attacked by pirates a week ago, and then he didn't tell the wife. So that information, you go, oh, that's very suspicious. And that at the start, you know, it's one of the people that got invited, because how else would the pirates know to come at this precise location? And do you want to have a guess of who the mastermind between the who invited the pirates?
Oh, I'm guessing it's either the husband or the ex-partner or something.
Ding ding ding, the ex-partner.
Yeah.
Not really a twist with that. Like, you know, when the ex-partner shows up, I was suspicious from it. And that's what I mean by it's not really that original. It's kind of, you know, the ex-partner.
What's their motive? Like, why do they want to see everyone get kidnapped?
Oh, basically for the money. And, you know, there was other twists that one of the bride's friends was involved as well. So they hooked up. They wanted money.
So it's a list of completely unrealistic scenarios. Someone organizes a wedding and someone goes, hey, let's get pirates to kidnap the wedding party and make money off it. Something that would never happen. Like, no, like I believe pirates would come, but I don't believe that someone could contact pirates and go, hey, how about you take some people ransom for me?
Yeah, and basically the plot wouldn't have happened if the bride's father invited the ex, the whole thing. The pirates wouldn't even known about the wedding.
Did they have a wedding in the end?
Yeah, basically.
Well, they get married, but they're in shambles and they don't care how they look, and they just want to get it done.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, this movie just seems very predictable, what you'd expect. It's been done and done before.
Yeah. So, probably sounds like I'm not talking that good about it, but besides making me laugh, it kind of really didn't do much. There's one scene when the bride and groom are attracted to each other, and then the groom's mother comes in and says, oh, you two can't be together, it's not traditional, and then it's like, you know, predictable things.
Okay, so there's one somewhat funny scene, and the rest is you just know what's going to happen. So who's Lenny Kravitz's role? Is he the ex-partner in this movie, or who's he play?
He's the ex.
The ex-partner. He's also the father of Catwoman in the latest Batman, if you didn't know that.
Okay.
That's his daughter. Yeah, just intrigued what role he would play, because he's not really an actor, he's a musician. So that's what you think about it. I probably won't watch it. I already know it happens, you know. It's a very predictable movie. I guess I could probably watch the trailer and that would cover it. So
if you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe, hit the notification bell. And if you enjoyed this video, there'll be video at the end. See you next time. Bye-bye.